Amanda Birkett. I work at OSF St. Francis Medical Center in Peoria, Illinois. I am what is referred to as a clinical laboratory science. Currently in the field, we are transitioning over to medical laboratory science, but right now you can kind of hear them interchangeably. We also have a histotechnology program that I'll briefly talk about. What you see right here is our facility. This is we just built this larger addition. It's called the Milestone. I'm sure you guys are familiar with it. But this entire building is the laboratory. So, clinical laboratory science is kind of like a broader aspect of the laboratory science, whereas cytology is more specific. We deal with a lot more different fields, which I'll discuss here in a little bit. A couple of these slides are a little bit wordy, so I'll apologize in advance. In the clinical and pathology laboratory, a highly skilled medical team of pathologists, as Jessica mentioned, specialists, technologists, and technicians work together to determine the presence or absence of disease and provide valuable data needed to make diagnosis and evaluate the effectiveness of treatment. So that's exactly what I do in a nutshell. It said about, I believe the last figure was about 80% of all medical decisions are based upon that lab. So anytime that a doctor wants to go ahead and treat something, normally it's based upon the information that we as a laboratory provide. So who works in the laboratory? Well, we have the phlebotomists who predominantly collect the blood specimens. They're the ones who are going on the field, actually interacting with the patients and collecting the specimens. We have the histotechnicians and histotechnologists. Difference between a technician and a technologist is the technician is the associate, technologist is the bachelor's. We also have the cytotechnologists, which Jessica touched base, and then we have the clinical laboratory technicians and the clinical laboratory scientists. Scientists being at the bachelor level and technicians at the associate level. These professionals are problem solvers. You know, Jessica touched base on a lot of the highlights. But if you like mysteries, I remember in high school my favorite thing was microscope work, so I really, you know, went into that field with this. Challenging, and you have to be responsible. You know, you are giving results to doctors who treat upon your results. You have to work well under pressure. I work in the blood bank department. It is a very high stress environment. We're a level one trauma center. A lot of times the doctors are calling and they want blood now. They don't necessarily understand that you just can't throw blood at them and it be acceptable, no transfusion reaction. So it's our job to screen the units to find compatible blood for patients. You have to communicate well. We interact a lot with the doctor's physicians. We have a lot of residents who come to OSF. A lot of times they'll call and say, hey, I have a patient that has X, Y, and Z. What kind of tests do I need to order? Are detail-oriented and organized. Organization is a big thing. A lot of people don't think about that, but that definitely plays a key. Also, multitask. A lot of times we're given, you know, 10, 15 specimens. You have to prioritize which one do you have to do first. Are they STED? Are they ER patient? Are they an ICU patient? You have to set high standards for themselves and are fascinated by science. So a couple of general job duties that we do is we perform lab tests. They are chemistry, microbiology, hematology, which is the blood specimens, all these different departments. Can I skip ahead? Monitor tests, problem solve, basically touch base. So skipping over into the areas of the laboratory. Cytology is a very specific form of the laboratory. They deal a lot with the cell morphology, stuff like that. Clinical laboratory sciences is a broader field. Depending on if you work at a larger or smaller facility, you can become a generalist or a specialist. OSF being a larger facility, it's only our third shift that are generalists. Us on first shift and second shift are specialists. Our volume is so large that we deal with only one specific department. Smaller hospitals and clinics, you could be generalist and you deal with more simpler tests and then you send the more complex tests out. So hematology, coagulation, that's how your blood clots. Your body has to be in a constant state. hemostasis. So you don't want it to clot, you don't want to bleed. So we measure that. Clinical chemistry, hormones, electrolytes, all that's in clinical chemistry, toxicology. Immunohematology transfusion service, fancy word for blood bank. We do all the blood testing. We don't do the actual blood collection. A lot of the facilities such as Red Cross do the collection. We do the testing. So we're screening the patient for any antibodies. If they do have antibodies, then we have to find compatible blood for them. Microbiology is one of the larger places in the laboratory. They're going to be your gram stain, your bacteria, your cultures, your sensitivities. If a doctor wants to figure out what kind of antibiotic to treat a certain bacteria, they order that. Parasitology and mycology, which is the fungus and parasites. Urinalysis, my least favorite, but definitely more of the important, you know, kidney function. And serology, which is the antigen-antibody reactions. So here's a couple different pictures talking about each of the fields. Hematology, what we do, we're kind of like the screening for blood morphology. You know, what is their red count? What is their white count? What is their platelet count? We also do like malaria screening. It is pretty automized, I guess that's how you want to call it. This is the different cells in the blood that we look at. This is a picture of us actually making a smear. We smear out the blood, stain it, look at it. Here's flow cytometry. This is one of our specialized departments. Not all facilities have this. OSF is lucky that we do have this. This is a very interesting field. Unfortunately, I know little about because it's still growing. But what it does is you take a blood sample and it goes through a flow chamber and it hits a laser. As that laser hits those cells, it refracts the light and places it on a scattergram. Technologists and technicians look at these scattergrams and they bring it down to the pathologist who can diagnose such things as leukemias, which is a bone marrow cancer. So this is definitely a very exciting field. We can also do blood specimens go through the flow cytometry. Coagulation, which is the blood clotting. We can measure, actually quantify how fast your blood will clot. If it doesn't clot, that's also something. As your body breaks down clots, there's also what we have is called fibrin degradation products. We can actually quantify that and give the physician kind of an idea of how the patient's doing. It's also why certain medications, I'm sure you guys have heard of Coumadin and Morphine. It is a blood thinner that a lot of people who have strokes and heart attacks. It's a very fine balance of the medication, how much to give. They do it based upon what is called a proton, and that's done in the coagulation department. Clinical chemistry, this is also one of the larger departments like microbiology, doing a lot of the EIAs, hormone testing, electrolytes. We can do cardiac markers, actually tell a physician if they have a heart attack. Stuff like that is done. We have electrophoresis, also in clinical chemistry. Immunohematology, transfusion medicine, this is blood bank, this is the actual testing, how we find antibodies and antigens in blood. As I said, we don't do the actual collection, we have facilities to do that, but we do the testing of the blood and make sure patients have compatible blood. Microbiology, gram staining, all that. Picture of gout, the sensitivity plates. This is our anaerobe chamber. Not too many facilities have that, so that's exciting. Some bacteria has to grow without the presence of oxygen, so we're able to culture that and identify that in our anaerobe chamber. And then our parasitology and mycology, we also are able to grow the specific fungi, identify it so the proper treatment can be given to the patient. Your analysis, you know, doing the pH, acetone, glucose, all that is tested in the laboratory. Serology, antigen, antibody identification, a lot of like HIV, stuff like that can be quantified in serology. This is molecular diagnostic. This is one of the larger growing fields in the laboratory that we deal with. I'm sure a lot of you guys in your undergrad years have dealt with this. PCR is definitely becoming a very huge part of our microbiology department. We started just doing MRSAs. Now we can do C. diff, which is a bacteria. So as opposed to culturing the bacteria, which could take 24 to 72 hours, we're able to give a positive or negative within an hour. We have NAT, nucleic acid testing, single strain displacement, real-time PCR, FISH. A lot of this is very exciting. A lot of it's done down in our cytogenetics, which is kind of another offset like cytology that does it, but it is done in the laboratory also. So a lot of stuff you see in these television shows is what we do. Going specifically into the CLS program, unlike cytology, we have what is referred to as a 3+1 or 4+1. I am a 3+1, which I did 3 years of undergrad at Bradley University, and my last year was done on site. My degree is medical technology. We have also what is the 4+1 program is when you already have your bachelor's and you come into this program. So say you already have an undergrad in biology, then you go to this program and then you get a certification or are able to sit for the boards. The program director is Carol Becker. All the information is at this website. Just like cytology, we have lectures and clinical daily. Typically, it is clinicals in the morning, about 7:20 to about 1 o'clock, depending on the day. And then we have lectures for 1 to 2 hours after that. Predominantly, you are learning in the laboratory. You are working side by side with our technologists, learning, working on patient samples. This is our prereqs. We do require that you have 16 hours of biology and 16 hours of chemistry. The program is competitive, so you really, you know, to compete with this, with the other students, this is kind of what you're looking at. Minimum of 2.75 is the GPA. Let's talk a little bit more about this. It is 45 weeks, so I think that comes to about 10 months. We take 6 students. I think last year we had about 30 applicants, so it is competitive. There are 3 programs in Illinois, so this is not the only one. There are other options. I believe there's one in Springfield and a couple up in Chicago on the suburbs. Briefly talk about this. I'm not too familiar with because this is not what my degree is, but it is offered at St. Francis, so I wanted to touch base on it. It is the histotechnology program. That is mostly dealing with the tissue and the actual specimens that come from surgery. So grossing is the actual full tissue. We have sectioning, then we section out those tissue, we stain it, and we look at kind of the bigger picture of it. So here's some pictures of the laboratory where they're grossing and bedding. So in bedding, they're actually dehydrating the specimens, and then we can add our own stains, or depending on what the actual tissue is, treat it differently. Sectioning, you know, each person has their own sectioning place. Staining, different stains, depending on what you're testing for, we have different stains that we can stain the tissues for. These are just more staining pictures. This is our autopsy. This is actually kind of creepy, but, you know, science, I find it very interesting. I call it the body parts room, but all our body parts, tissues, everything like that is kept. This is our autopsy room. We actually do autopsies. We don't do as much as we normally do because the coroner of Peoria has taken it over. We mostly do just the ones that are medically deceased at the hospital. Briefly about the histotechnology program, it's September through March. Just like cytology, this is a hybrid program. So it is through Blackboard. There are some face-to-face lectures. Clinicals daily. We did have a student that did her clinical at a different hospital, so you don't necessarily need to do your clinical at OSF. National certification exam, just like cytology and the medical laboratory program. Prereqs, not as hard, not as competitive, but it is 8 hours of biology and 8 hours of chemistry with at least a 2.5 GPA. So here's a picture. This is actually one of the pathologists' work room. It's a six scope where we have the pathologist here and a couple of students, and they're looking at blood smears. And then this is our classroom. We used to take more students. That's why there's so many chairs, but we do only take six students right now. Big question is employment opportunities. We mostly do go to laboratories. More of the larger facilities and smaller facilities. A lot of our clinics tend to associate with a larger laboratory, just how healthcare is going right now. It's hard for them to stand alone as a clinic, so it's cheaper for them to send their specimens to the larger facilities. Some physician office laboratories do like point of care basic testing. Forensic and veterinary laboratories, the hospital across the street actually does veterinarian specimens. Research biotechnology, a lot of the pharmaceutical companies. When I graduated, I was looking more in pharmaceuticals, places like Eli Lilly in Indianapolis. They do have positions for medical technologists when I graduated, at least. Education and a stepping stone to other professions. Just like cytology, we've had people go to med school afterwards, pathologist assistant, physician's assistant. All that is very beneficial when you've had that basic laboratory experience. One of the reasons why I did go into this program is we have 100% of our program graduates have found employment in the fields. Laboratories in general, on my shift alone, there's probably 40, 50 people that work in the laboratory, and that's doubled on day shift. So there is more job opportunities. Right now, OSF has three positions open for medical laboratories technology. The program does have bragging rights that 100% of everyone who's gone through the program has passed their boards. So that's definitely very exciting. There is a national shortage across the country. A lot of places like Chicago definitely pay well for medical laboratory scientists. Starting salary, you're looking about $40,000. Histotechnology is about $35,000. I know everyone wants to know what you make when you start, but it also depends on experience and where you go. Obviously, if you look up in the Chicago area, you may start at $60,000 depending on your experience. So, you know, that's something you have to take in mind too. Here's the website, OSF St. Francis. If you look on careers, we have a website that outlines everything that I've touched based on. So